I'm Lockie Evenson.
I'm William Morgan.
And this is the Open Source Show. I'm Lockie Evenson, a PM at Azure.
And I'm William Morgan, one of the creators of Linkerd.
Okay, William, service meshes.
Yes.
We have a service mesh, okay? We've made it this far. Where do we go from here with service meshes?
Well, the moment you have a service mesh, you solved all problems.
Right.
So everything.
Obviously.
So that's really all there is to it.
So who are the people that are operating the service mesh itself? I kind of get the developer use case and the developer workflow, but who do you see in the wild as the people that are actually responsible for the service mesh?
Yeah, so in our experience, the role or the title is a little different depending on which company you're in, but it typically falls under this role of the platform owner. It's the same person who's bringing in things like Kubernetes and Docker and a CI, CD system. They're building this internal platform for their developers, and the developers are going to run their code on it. And this is a person who is not only picking the service mesh, but also has to operate it, and is on the hook for it, and is worrying about the health of it.
So what kind of problems are they coming across in terms of, they have the service mesh, they're responsible for it?
Yeah, so the service mesh is new enough that it's still falling into the category of, oh, this is a new thing, and whenever something breaks, I'm going to blame the service mesh.
Right.
So that's a lot of the motivation for us adding as much diagnostics as we can to Linkerd, so that when things are behaving in a strange, unexpected way, you can actually dig in. The service mesh sits at the intersection of all these different layers, right? It needs the underlying layer three, layer four network to be in place. It needs the applications to be behaving. It needs the orchestrator to be orchestrating things.
Right.
And if any of those things go wrong, then the behavior that you see out of the service mesh can be strange. And then you have to understand, okay, where is the source of the problem?
Right. So can you actually use the service mesh to monitor the service mesh?
Yes. Great question.
Okay.
That's right. So the first time you install Linkerd, before you've added the data plane anywhere, and you boot up the dashboard, the only thing you see is the control plane there, because
right.
The control plane runs its own data plane as part of it, and you can use that to inspect, okay, here are all the different components of the control plane, here's their success rate, here's their request volume, here's their latency, and that's one of the basic ways of understanding what the health of the service mesh.
Okay. So if I have a problem, one common thing that I would like to know is, how do I isolate at what point the system is broken? How do I actually isolate quickly and easily where exactly the problem may lie?
Well, this is one of the things that the service mesh can actually really help with, because one of those components that we talked about in the early part of this was the visibility layer.
Right.
What Linkerd can add is a layer of what we call golden metrics across each of your services and visibility into things like success rate and latency distribution, and we can do it in a way where you don't have to modify the application at all to get those metrics. We can paint a picture of what the health is of each of the services in your application. And in fact, we can even draw the what we call the service topology, which is which services talk to which other services. So you'll have A talking to B, talking to C, talking to E, F, D, Q, whatever.
Right.
And we can draw that map in real time. It turns out that's actually a very difficult thing to do if you're just looking at the code or if you're just writing things down in a spreadsheet, because it changes all the time. We derive that map from the observed traffic.
And who retains the role of actually watching the service mesh itself as you see it in these production environments? Who, is there an app operator? Is it actually the app developer? Is there somebody actually controlling the service mesh itself?
Yeah, so there's kind of two categories of people who we try to satisfy with the service mesh. The first is a platform owner themselves. And they're the operator, so they have to feel really comfortable with this thing. They have to understand what it's doing. But there's also the developer. So the developer who is deploying things to this platform, there's a lot of value they can get out of the service mesh too.
Okay, so is there such thing as a fail-safe service mesh failure? So in the event that it goes down, my services may still function in a partial outage or an outage case?
Yeah. So the service mesh, along with your microservices application, is a distributed system. And one of the core tenets of a distributed system is that there are going to be failures, and you're never going to be able to predict them. So Linkerd has been designed to take into account all sorts of different ways that things can fail, ranging from one of the hosts that this control plane component was running on just died, all the way to, we have a network partition, and these two nodes can no longer talk to each other.
Okay, so clarify this for me. Can I use the service mesh to monitor the service mesh?
Yes.
Do you use the components to self-monitor?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So when you install the Linkerd control plane, before you add the data plane to anything else, The only thing that you have visibility into is Linkerd itself.
Okay.
And you can look in the dashboard, you can see each of the components, you can see what their health is, you can see the request volume. That's a big, big part of giving you visibility into what is actually happening in the service mesh, which is vital as an operator.
Okay, so I'm bought in on service meshes. Where do I go to learn more?
So the best place to go is linkerd.io. We have a website for our open source service mesh. And all of our activity happens on GitHub, so you can also go to github.com/linkerd. Finally, we have a very friendly and active community that is in slack.linkerd.io, and you should definitely join and check it out.
So all those links will be in the description. Along with that, you can go to opensource.microsoft.com to learn more. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and click subscribe. And thanks for joining us. Thank you, William.
Thanks, Lockie.